If you take a look at, for example, all the previous year questions of the UPSC Civil Services Examination prelims paper, especially for the subject of polity, you can notice a few, you know, what you can say, patterns which arise out of that. One, that all questions are inspired from current affairs. It is the current events which are appearing in the newspaper for the last 15 months that have been the most, what you can say, prominent source from which the question on the UPSC prelims examination are being asked. Right? So all questions are inspired from current affairs. By, for example, inspiration from current affairs, I mean two kinds of things. Either they are directly inspired by current affairs, you have maybe direct questions from current affairs, or you have what you can call indirect questions from current affairs. Okay, so let's say, for example, if a question comes like this, you have a current affair this time with regard to, let's say, for example, the electoral bonds, right? So let's say, for example, if the question comes like this, the electoral bond scheme was made operational by amendments to which of these acts. Okay, let's say, for example, the first option is let's say Finance Act 2017. Second option is, let's say, Representation of People's Act 1951. Let's say the third option is the Companies Act 2013. Right? So, electoral bond schemes was made operational by amendments to which of these following acts? Right? Now, if you take a look at, for example, the ways of doing this, you have A, 1, 2, and 3. B, 1 and 2, C, 2 and 3, and D, 1 and 3. Please take a look at this, please, class. Can you see what is the correct answer to this? Just by whatever we have seen in the classes, or we have, Mother, you must have read something in the newspaper. This is what is kind of a very typical prelims question, which is coming directly from the current updates. Do you see the point? Okay, can you give me an answer to this, class? Can you take an attempt at it? What is the correct answer to this? Meaning, I'm just trying to go inside the mind of the, what you can say, the examiner, the paper setter. And I'm trying to, in a way, lay out for you how the paper setter would be making questions. Can you take an attempt at it, class? Yes, very good. The answer is A, 1, 2, and 3. So let's say this is a direct question that comes from the, what you can call, electoral bonds case and updates. Now, let's say if the paper setter has to make an indirect question out of it. And again, I'm just giving you a demonstration as to what an indirect question in this particular matter may look like. If, let's say, an indirect question is asked by the examination, which says something like this, that the Finance Act 2017 was the provisions of Finance Act 2000. Which created the electoral bond scheme were recently struck down by the Supreme Court. For which of the following reasons? Let's say this is a more complex, or let's say at least lengthy question. Okay. Let's say it was ultra vires. Point number A, violated basic structure. C, writ powers, or let's say D, now take a look at this question. This is what you can call an indirect question that the UPSC paper setter may make out of the, what you can call, the electoral bond scheme. At this point of time, what I'm basically trying to do, I'm trying to in a way invite you to and look at, take a look at the mind of the paper setter, the person who sets the examination. What does that person think like? Okay. Now, what I'm meaning to say is that what you see over here, the first question that you're taking a look at over here, this is a more direct question, meaning this is a question which has been taken from a newspaper article, and the information in that article itself is made into a question. But this is a slightly more layered question. This is a slightly more complicated question. For this, a deeper reading of possibly editorials, etc., etc., is needed. You are not going to be able to answer this question only on the basis of a simple, what you can say, understanding of a particular activity. What is the correct answer over here? The correct answer is D. Illegally bypassed the Rajya Sabha because the Finance Act had passed itself as a money bill. And that is what the Supreme Court said, that the passing the Finance Act as a money bill is, what you can say, going to be subjected to a kind of a judicial review. So, a Finance Act in the provisions of electoral bonds cannot be made a provision of Finance Act because the Finance Act is not strictly a money bill. It is supposed to be either a financial bill or an ordinary bill, and therefore the will of the Rajya Sabha cannot be struck now. Theek, in any case, we are not dealing with the facts of the matter currently. We are just trying to understand for you how the questions upon these areas are going to be structured.